Good morning. How is the lockdown, the last year, the isolation affecting agoraphobia? Agoraphobia is the fear of, at its extreme, even leaving one's house. It often starts due to panic attacks, and the person becomes fearful of the areas and things and situations that cause panic attacks, causing them to withdraw further and further and further to avoid the panic. Sometimes you can have agoraphobia without panic. Agoraphobia, just the fear of open space where you are vulnerable, where you don't feel safe. And something like having a medical illness, something that is unpredictable, can make you feel unsafe if you're not in the security of someone you trust or the safety of your own home. For a variety of reasons, people can wind up making their life smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. And it's a spectrum disorder, and it's at its extreme. You are locked in your home. You do not leave your home. At one point, I was at that extreme. I referred to years back, I haven't talked much about agoraphobia in some time. I consider myself an agoraphobic in a snow globe. My world is larger than my home, but I still have difficulties traveling, especially alone. Going new places and traveling without an individual that I trust and feel safe with. Being that, like many anxiety disorders, the way you overcome agoraphobia is through exposure, gradual, slow exposure to the outside world over and over and over again over time, expanding your capacities, your distance, your stress threshold for new situations, new places, new environments, even the things, if you had panic, that triggered your panic, and to be able to endure that. It's exposure therapy, and you begin to branch your world out. As the world has closed in, and those of us who have these particular issues haven't had to deal with relating to the outside world, it's not been a part and parcel of our normal activities anymore. If we go to work, we may still just go to work and come home, and that's about the extent of it. It limits the exposure that we have now adjusted to a certain level of tolerating, and can cause a major backslide in the ability to cope with and tolerate what once was copable and tolerable, and the person's life begins to shrink again. And other people with different psychological issues, such as OCD, if their particular fear was of germs, and now there is a pandemic, can begin to shut themselves down and close themselves off due to fear of catching the pandemic, and newly find themselves with agoraphobia. It is important, if you're having these issues or if you find yourself backsliding, that you continue to push yourself. Continue to try to travel alone, continue to take walks outside of your home, continue to try to maintain the ground that you have gained, even though the places that you may be able to explore are not the same as they were before. That you continue to explore and continue to try to be as independent and out of doors as possible, or you will find that the less you are exposed to your fear, the bigger the fear. So it's important during this shutdown process that we continue to go, to get out, to socialize, to expand, to take transportation, to leave, to engage in things like public transit or planes or crossing bridges or whatever was the fear factor, to continue to do these things as they are possible and to do them on your own as much as possible. And if you find that your phobias of germs or other things are beginning to constrict your life down to a point you do not want to find yourself in, a situation of agoraphobia, it is utterly life eliminating and debilitating that you seek out help. If you find your walls literally, not just figuratively and societally closing in, but literally closing in again, or for the first time, where you're afraid to leave your home, that you seek help and prevent your world from shrinking and being taken away from you. Good morning. Goodbye. Get outside. No matter how cold it is, no matter how scary it is, don't let your mind, don't let the shutdown, don't let the pandemic rob you of your ability to leave your home and maneuver your world. Good morning.